I take it you have basic questions then. Do you want to go ahead and ask me those?
Oh, absolutely. Okay. So if I home equity line of credit, what questions do I need to ask?
What questions do you need to ask?
Yes, in order for me to do this program, the velocity.
Okay, so when you're going into yet any kind of line of credit, first you need to verify what your own credit score is. Do you know what that is?
Yeah, I was trying to find on the, so I have, I do it on Credit Karma and my score IQ.
Mm-hmm.
And it said consumer FICO 8722, okay. Mortgage FICO 2666, and then a TransUnion 679.
Okay, so you should be really close to what scores you need to get a second position HELOC. When you call the bank, you will want to ask them what credit score they are looking for, okay? Some will ask for 700. So if you may have to work on your debt or your credit a little bit so that you can get it up over 700. But most for second position HELOCs, you're talking about a 680. So you're really, really, you're really there.
Okay.
So when you, for goodness sake, do not go to Bank of America because they have really, really high HELOC rates right now. I don't know what they think they're doing, but we're talking 11%. That's the highest in the nation that I know of currently that I've actually dealt with. So try to stick with your local credit union and see if you can't stay around a 9% or less. Okay.
Okay.
Then what they're going to base that HELOC off of is usually 80% of your value of your home. So do you know the value of your home?
Yeah. So it was weird. Just a few days ago, it was 479. And then when I looked at Redfin? It was, then it went to 453. Okay. In a matter of a couple of days or like a week or so. And then I owe 370.
Okay. So let's talk about that. Okay. So if it's at 425, for example, you would have 340 available. And if you owe, you said you owed 330?
370.
Oh, you owe 370?
Yes.
Okay. So the second position HELOC doesn't sound like it's going to work for you.
Okay.
You're not, you don't have enough equity in your home yet.
Even at 453?
Well, if it was at 453, let's see. No, it would still be 362. If you got a balance of 370, what's your interest rate on that?
5.25.
I was going to say, it sounds like you've got a high interest rate. Let's see, you don't have a score. You have to have over 700 to move into a first lien HELOC, which at 450,000, that would be 405. So you would be able to move into a first lien HELOC. Do you have credit cards currently?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Are you using them the way the videos teach?
Well, I was starting to. I was starting to do what you were saying as paying... putting my income into paying those off. I mean, so the one I owe the most on, I try to, when I get paid, you pay all that. I get like 36.72 biweekly. So I try to put most of my income into the one credit card and pay my bills with that credit card.
Okay.
If I'm understanding how we're doing this, that's what I kind of been doing. I haven't been doing it that long though.
Okay. So the way you're going to get your credit score over 700 sounds like to me that whatever you can put into the credit card two or three times a week will boost your score. So let's say you have a $200 payment due, on the due date. You would put in, you know, maybe $50 once a week or, you know, maybe $25 twice a week to meet that $200 amount that they want for on the due date. The reason that when we do that, we stop the cycle. They have an interest cycle of 25 days. And every single time you can hit that, and I don't care if it's with $5, when you put a payment into a credit card, you are interrupting the interest cycle. And when you do that, you're cutting your interest charges. But that causes an extreme boost to your credit score sometimes. I don't even know why, really. Mm-hmm. So if I were you, I would start putting those small multiple payments into the credit cards and see at the next reporting date what your credit score is. If you can get the credit score up to over 700, you could move into a first lien HELOC possibly, which I said I was going to give you if you have a $450,000 value on your home, it would give you 405. So that means after you pay off the 370, you're going to have about 35,000 to work with.
Oh, okay. No, that's good. I really appreciate I definitely can do the multiple payments. That's good.
Yeah, that should really cause a boost in your score. So I would kind of go that way just for, till your next reporting date to see how high your score is because they really won't touch you below a 700.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah,
So
let's go ahead.
I was just going to say, so we also have the automated system in the event that you can't get into a line of credit and you're really wanting to. Okay.
What's
I'm going to put that link in here because I know people are going to ask me that, and I'm going to go ahead
Sure.
and put it in here, and that way you can watch it. This link is to a webinar that I did previously for the MoneyMax account, and it doesn't require a line of credit. So when I see people having problems with that, I'm like, okay, we can do it this way because it gets you out of debt just as fast, but you don't need a line.
Oh, that's a good option.
Yeah. Okay. So that webinar is in there. If you want to watch that and then you want to go ahead and get your own personal analysis, that's absolutely free. And I have a team set up just to take care of my clients with the software so that I know that one, you're getting all the information you need before you have to make any decisions. And two, you can come back for training with my same team in the event, that you need to add in more debt or you've got bonus money you want to put in. There's all kinds of different reasons that you might need to talk with the team member. So it's a once you're in for a lifetime and it's free coaching, free upgrades. So it's just a really it's a good thing to have if one, you have multiple properties or two, you can't get a line of credit. It definitely can help you still get out of debt.
Oh, great. Okay.
Okay. Thank you all so much for taking time to come and have a conversation about your finances and get things in order. And I pray the best for each of you that you're doing really, really well and everything's going to be smooth sailing from here on out. Okay. All right. I guess I'll see you guys in the next video. Okay. You all have a great weekend. Bye-bye.
Thank you.